Alexa, stop.
Hi.
Good morning. So it's interesting. The cameras went down and we had a conversation in the barn. You know, we made this bed and now we have to sleep in it. Basically what I'm saying is being live 24/7 and vlogging our family life is kind of unique on YouTube, right? Some people vlog, very famous vloggers vlog all the time and they have kids, but people don't get to see their home 24/7, right? Like, our followers almost kind of know when we're home and not home by assumption, right? Like, sure. Oh, I saw a car pull out of the driveway, because you guys can see that.
Ooh, they got a lot of packages today. I wonder if they're animal crackers.
Exactly. So you guys see a lot, and we need to decide, are you seeing too much, not enough, whatever. And we're on every social platform known to man other than MySpace.
That was a joke.
It's okay. Not around.
He's going to ramble, but I'm going to make it real simple. When we started this channel, we decided what we were comfortable with, what we were not comfortable with. And my line in the sand is with Aaron's travel schedule, I don't want anybody knowing when my husband's not home. That puts me in a sketchy situation when all of YouTube, because you don't know who's watching this cam, we've got a lot of lurkers, when all of YouTube knows that he's traveling, that means they also know that I'm home alone.
I travel a lot too.
He travels a lot. They also know that that means I'm home alone with four kids. And so in order for me to sleep well at night, I need to know that I feel safe, and having his travel scheduled all over YouTube and Facebook is not okay. Unfortunately, there's a double-edged sword here because I know how to do this. So it is part of his job to be on Twitter and announce trade shows that he has to go to for his real job. And yes, part of that is also getting ready for this YouTube conference that's coming up and the Durham Fair and all of that. What happens on Twitter stays on Twitter is pretty much
what we're asking.
Is what we're asking for. And we're not doing that. Look, we're not upset at anybody. We've had this come up a couple different times. And I get it, you guys. When you're not in that situation, you might not think about it this way. You figure, oh, it was on that platform. Why can't it be on this platform? This one is just a little more open and like, I feel
YouTube community.
Yeah. And also, I feel like YouTube is less restrictive, like as far as who we know is watching. And we could have some creepers that are here and we don't even know it. And we have other people in our own town.
I should have built a gate before I built a house of pie.
You should have built a gate before you went live on YouTube.
Yeah, a long time ago.
Before this YouTube even started, we've had people pull down our driveway. And, you know, we have people who are in our own town who watch our channel, kids, you know, all that. So we just want to make sure that I can sleep well at night. Are you putting two in each?
No, one scoop of this.
One and one. We've changed their food because it's the end of the season.
One scoop of that.
Oh, look, you're spilling it everywhere.
Yep.
Surprise.
So basically, we're just saying, you know,
I'm sorry if anybody got their feelings hurt yesterday.
No, we're not trying to hurt anybody's feelings. And I'm going to have to do better at the way I post on other platforms. For example, my Facebook's totally off the limits for anybody.
Mine is too.
Yeah, I have like 50 friends on my real Facebook. So in other words, stop friend requesting me. It's not going
to
happen.
Look, it's not. There's certain things that need to be private. Right. We love you guys. I mean, I actually love you guys more after the Durham Fair than before the Durham Fair.
It's so funny. Tell them that story about the Durham Fair.
Yeah, so
about
I'm sitting.
How you felt bad.
How I felt bad?
You missed YouTube.
I did miss YouTube. I think I even put it in chat the other day when I came and checked in on you guys. Yeah, I was really missing my YouTube family. I felt like everybody who came up to the booth was really nice and everything and loved them, but, you know, there's
they felt
just...
felt like strangers.
They did. They felt like strangers, and I was really missing my YouTube community, so...
Oh,
we did have a couple people from YouTube stop by, some people who were here for our open house event. They stopped by, so it felt like a little familiar... That's not a word. Familiar. Familiar...
I felt like they knew who we were.
And I felt like I knew them because they knew us. Then there's other people who are like, I don't know who you are. And
never heard of you.
Never heard of you. They felt like strangers. And you know me. I get a little anxious around people I don't know.
So in other words, I wouldn't Google your name find your home address, and then come into this chat room and drop that name.
Oh, and tell people that you're not going to be home.
Right. So that's kind of what we're saying. Yeah. If it's on another platform, it almost belongs there. Like, you know, ESPN, Fox News, CNBC are all different platforms, and it's very rare that they talk about the same subject. They might highlight, oh, the baseball game was great, but ESPN is where you're going to get every little detail, and it stays there. You get what I'm saying? Yeah. So, like, Twitter might have different information than YouTube has, and LinkedIn might have. But, again, we made this bed. We need to figure out how to sleep in it. And
we're just asking
so that's it
for you guys to respect the fact.
Oh, I haven't seen Aaron in a couple of days. Where is he? If you know the answer to that question,
it's like what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas.
That's a good one.
What happens on Twitter stays on Twitter.
Right, or Instagram.
Yeah, but very rarely do we ever post something on Instagram like Aaron's traveling.
That's not where Instagram's meant to do that. Instagram's meant to be pretty and flashy. Twitter's meant to be like, hey, I'm at this conference. Are you here? And I meet up with work people, and that's what happens.
Right.
Got it. Get it.
Well, it's also why your Twitter handle is Aaron Syman and not Syman Says Farms.
Even though we do have one of those,
we don't use it because we don't go anywhere. Hello. Okay, so that's it. I'm really sorry if anybody got offended yesterday. Our moderators. Can I talk?
Sorry, but it wasn't just yesterday, is my point. It's been boiling up.
Okay.
Sorry.
Very sorry, but the moderators really handled it the best that they could. They're representing us and our privacy policies. Privacy policies. We actually are adding a little something to like the chat rules about the whole cross platforms. If you read something somewhere else on another social media platform, to please keep it on that social media platform. And you know, it's just out of respect for me and my safety. So. I hope that's all I really need to say. Love you!